what is this program called? This program or this, you know, problem is called 01 knapsack problem. Okay, be careful with the names of it. This is not just knapsack, it is 01 knapsack problem. Okay, that you got to keep in mind. And when you're talking about 01 knapsack program, what do you think is going to happen in this? Okay, so let me sort of clear the screen. Yeah, hopefully. Once again, I'll just make the screen is ready. Now we are ready. Okay, so let me start with regard to what needs to be done. Okay, this is known as 01 knapsack problem. Okay, very important for you to keep in mind. Okay, that it is called 01 knapsack problem. Why it is called 01 knapsack problem? Before that, we need to know a little bit of the older versions of it. We saw a knapsack problem before. Okay, what we used to call it, we used to call it as a fractional problem. What is why it was called as a fractional problem? Because if there was, say, 3 kgs, okay, I'm taking kgs only as an example. If there were 3 kgs and in the knapsack only 2 kgs was possible, what we used to do? We used to take only 2 kg among this. So 2 out of 3 kg only we used to take, and we used to put that 2 kg into the knapsack. Okay, that is what we used to do, right? So that's the most important part to keep in mind, that we used to keep only the half a part of it, or only a fraction of it. That's why it was called as fractional knapsack. And we used to do it using TD method. Okay, what is the real-time examples you can give? If you are trying to build if you're trying to buy a tomato or a potato or any of the vegetables, okay, think you got a bag to your market. So what do you think? This bag will be taking maybe around, say, 2 kgs. And you want to buy tomato here. But the guy will say, see, I have 3 kgs with me, you please buy it. So what do you do? See, the bag is only 2 kgs. So what do you say? No, no, I can't buy this 3 kg. Okay, if I buy this 3 kg, the bag will, you know, get break, you know, it will sort of break. Okay, it gets spoiled. I can't take it home. So what do? You take only 2 kg out of it, right? You take only 2 kg out of the 3 kg that was given to it, and you put it into this bag like this, and you take it home. Okay, this is a fractional knapsack problem. Okay, it's a fractional knapsack problem. This you got to know. I'm probably pretty sure that you people know this, you know, how it is all done. Now, what happens when it comes to 01 knapsack problem? This is very much a non-fractional knapsack problem. Now, what is the meaning of non-fractional? You can't break it. Okay, there's no point of breaking it. You cannot break it. Okay, what is the example that you people may be thinking now? Okay, why can't we break it? Now, think of, you know, items like, I don't know, maybe a mixer. Okay, think of items maybe like a refrigerator. See, if you're taking a mixer, refrigerator, or even a television set, so what do? Can you break it into small parts? Okay, think that, you know, you'll either take the entire mixer with you, entire refrigerator with you, entire TV with you, or you will not take at all. Okay. You can't say, you know, give me half mixer, then, you know, half refrigerator. That is possible? No, it's not possible. People will not break you, you know, just because there's a refrigerator here. Just because you put it, you can't put this refrigerator into our auto. Okay, what they'll say, you know, see, take only half, other half you keep it here only. No, is it possible? No, it's not possible. Okay, that is not possible. So this is a non-fractional knapsack problem. What is the thing that you can see here? The thing here is you can't break it. That's why you can see it is a non-breakable problem. The real-time examples of all these things where you can't break this set of items. So only it's called 01 knapsack problem. Why it is called 0? Either you not select it. So be careful with the way I'm writing it. Either you not select it or 1 you select it. Even in the, you know, the problem what we taught with regard to knapsack, you came across what is known as X there. X of I. What was X of I? You put 1 or you put 0. You put 1 where you are selecting the entire item. You put 0 when you are not selecting the entire item. In this, you know, fractional, you used to put, you know, 2 by 3 also, or 0.66 also. Why? Because we used to take only fraction of it. Here, you are not going to get like that. You are either going to get 0 or 1. No more 0.66, 1.66, such things are not going to happen here. Okay, that is something that you got to keep in mind. That's the difference between people will ask you. Because it's even a lab program. See, it's a theory part. It's a lab program. You have to know each and everything. Okay. Today, I think the people who have, I think we are still lagging in B1. Because the B2 batch has really cleared a lot more programs compared to B1. So, if possible, I don't think so. It's possible today. Okay. If possible, we'll see this program for you for the first time. Or else, it will be B2 people who will be seeing the NAPSOC 01 NAPSOC program, which is 6A. Okay, first in the lab. Okay, now again, be careful here. This is a lab program, which is 6A. And what was 6B? 6B was again an NAPSOC program in greedy method. People will ask you this, you know, the difference between these two, they will ask you. And this comes in your dynamic programming concepts, module 4. This NAPSOC program comes in your greedy method, okay, which is module 3. So what is going to happen? In exam, you can either expect any one of these two. Either these two or, you know, any one of these two will be coming here. Okay, they will not be asking both. That's, you know, taking same question from two same concept. Okay, that's not going to happen. Two questions, they're not going to form using the same concept and all. Very, very less. Okay, so either this will come or this will come. However, you will be able to give. Okay, this you have already seen in internals also. This you are going to see now, okay, which will be there for your next entrance, okay, very as simple as that, okay. Next, start studying for your exams, okay, a few things, okay, see, one after other will be keep on joining, okay. I'm preparing a place where all the algorithms will be in one place, okay, so that, you know, you will see the document, you can get to know all the algorithm in one place, all the time complexities of these algorithms in one place, so that you see that you can easily sort of figure out, okay. But majority of it, algorithms, time complexities are very important only up to module 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, very less chances that you get these sort of things. It's all about problems here, different types of problems, okay, that you have to be very careful, okay, should be able to do it. It's a subject which will really make or break you people, okay. You can easily score a hell of a lot of marks here. At the same time, there's always a good probability that you may end up scoring very, very less marks. When I say very less marks, marks that really fail you, okay. That should not happen. So let me start with this problem. I told you very clearly that we came across 01 NAPSOC problem under dynamic programming. It is non-breakable, okay, very much non-breakable. What is the objective? The objective remains the same. The objective obviously remains the same. The objective is you need to maximize the profit, okay. See, the value, input, everything will remain the same. You need to maximize the profit, and whatever the weights that will be given to you, you need to put only that, you know, equal to your maximum weight, okay. Equal to your maximum weight, or you can put less also, but no one will do less. You're going to put the weight to the maximum weight. Okay, so what will be the input? Input will be the same thing. Okay, or what is the question they're going to ask you? They're going to give you the same thing. They're going to give the number of objects, which is n. Okay, they are going to give you the weights, okay, which is nothing but w. They are going to give you the profit, same thing, same input only. Okay, methods are changing. That's all, simple. Profits P, then of course they are going to give you even the maximum size of it. What is maximum size? M. All these things they are going to give you without any problem. What is your output? Output is only one simple. You need to figure out which objects are chosen, okay, which objects are not chosen. So based on this, what you figure out? You figure out your maximum profit. It's all about profit only. So only it's dynamic programming, okay. Even in greedy method also, it was maximum profit only. What you used to do in greedy method? You used to go with steps, right? You used to go with steps. What is the definition for dynamic programming? Dynamic programming says, please figure out all the possibilities, all possible solutions. In that solution, you choose the best solution. That is what they say. Dynamic programming. Okay? Choose everything. Choose, do it for everything. Choose the best one. In greedy method, they say, there are steps there. Please follow that steps. Blindly follow that steps. Don't worry about any other things. Okay. In very laymanic terms, this is how you need to explain things. Okay. let's start, you know, the problem of it. Again, I'm saying you, why it is called 0-1, you know, knapsack problem. Either you select it 1 or you not select it 0. Okay, as simple as that. So we are going to take one problem. Okay, we're going to take one problem. What we are going to do is, I'm going to teach you the most easier way of doing it. There is a formula also, just like how you used to have for knapsack also, there's a formula. Okay, but if you go with formula, there's always a good probability that you may sort of miss it. So we use a technique which we know. Okay, because at the end of the day, once you get the values correctly, then you can use that formula to sort of adjust those values. Okay, people in exam, they don't ask you whether you did the problem first, then you wrote the formula, or you wrote the formula because of that you forgot the values. No, you should be good enough, you should be smart enough to get the values correctly, and at the same time, formula is also matching those values. Okay, that value we are going to do it today. We have to be very smart. Okay, smart enough to always remember. Okay, you're always playing to the gallery. You are playing to the gallery of VT. Okay, you need to bring in that best marks from your side. So for that, whatever that is possible, you have to do, which is legal. Okay, when I say whatever that's possible, not copying and all, whatever that's legal, and whatever the way you can sort of, you know, come across the evaluator, you can do. Okay, so let me start with this. Okay, I'm going to take one problem, so be very careful with this. Okay, I'm going to take the problem. The maximum size of it is 8. Okay, the maximum weight, maximum size is nothing of a knapsack is equal to 8. The number of objects is equal to 4. What are the 4 objects? Any 4 objects. Okay, then the profits they have given. What is the profits they have given? The profits they have given is nothing but 5, 6, 1, 2. Okay, see, I'm going to send the same problem again, you know, for your notes also. But again, we are going to look in here also. Okay, then the weights they have given. Okay, what is the weights they have given? 4, okay, 5, 2, 3. This is the weights they have given. Is every input given here? Knapsack means 4 inputs. Have they given all 4? Yes. Okay, now my job. Now my job is to figure out my, what is known as maximum profit. So what is the step in this? The step, just like in your previous thing, okay, or step 1 is to make sure that you write everything, you know, you see all these things done. You see all these things, okay, be careful here in whatever the way I'm going to write. You are going to write, be careful, compared to this one, there's a little changes. Okay, small changes that you come across, those things you got to be careful. Okay, what's the step 1? Step 1, you are going to arrange. Okay, you are going to arrange all the weights. Be careful here. What is the thing I'm saying? They are talking about weights. You're going to arrange all the weights in ascending order. That's very important. Okay, you're doing it in ascending order means smaller first, bigger later. The same thing, correspondingly, profit should also be sort of put in ascending order. See, you can't just, you know, change this ascending order and then leave it like that only. Majority of them will do that mistake. They will be in a hurry. They will say, sir, I was in a hurry. You are in a hurry, the marks went with an hurry. That should not happen. Corresponding weights and profits should be kept in ascending order. Okay, fine. So what is going to happen with regard to weights? Weights will change now. Okay, weights will become equal to 2, 3, 4, 5. That is how it is going to change. Then the profits. Profits will be becoming what? 2, 3, 4, 5, what we got to weights. Then the profits will again change with the corresponding way. You need to change this also. So profits will also become 1, 2, 5, 6. Okay, this also will be changing. Okay, now the next step, the most important step. Okay, where you are going to write how all the things that are possible there. You are going to put all these things in form of a tabulation column or table. Okay, it's called tabulation method. You're going to put all these things in a tabulation method or a tabulation column or table. Simple as that. Okay, how you are going to put? Okay, this is the most important part. So please make sure that you're understanding it. Okay, if you know this table, if you know how to manage this table, the entire problem is fully done. Okay, later it's all about, you know, managing these values using our formulas that we can always do. Okay, so let me put that table for it. The table will be obviously be coming through like this. Okay, what are the things that will be having? What are the things that will not be having? Those things you got to keep in mind. Okay, First thing is, what is the weight they have given equal to 8? Okay, the maximum size of the knapsack they are given is equal to 8. Okay, so what you are going to do it for this in this method is you are going to write up to 8. Starting from 0 up to 8, you are going to write all the values, okay, in form of a columns. So what is going to happen? You are going to start with 0, okay, then 1. Like this, you are going to write up to 8. Okay, maximum size is, see, I told you it's dynamic programming. So which basically means you're going to figure out solutions for each and everything. For each and every maximum size, you are going to figure out. So what is up to the last one? Last one, the maximum size they are given was 8. So up to 8, you are going to write it like this. What was this? This was nothing but the weights. Okay, this is all nothing but weights only. So you can very clearly say that you are writing. Okay, once again, I'm going to write it neatly here. Okay, so we are going to write the weights here starting from 0 to 8. Why you need to write like this? Because it's dynamic programming. You need to find solution for each and everything, then figure out the best solution. Obviously, the best solution is with regard to 8. That will be coming at the last part of it. Okay, then towards the rows. Okay, towards the rows, you can see very clearly. Towards this side, you will be having two things here. What are not two things, three things then. You are going to choose what is known as here. You are going to choose what is known as I. So what is going to happen? This will be your W weights. Towards this side, you will be having your I. What is that I? Whether that particular, okay, you are going to choose that object or not with regard to X. The X, we will be seeing that later, but we are going to choose I here. Here, I means the number of objects. Again, you are going to start with what? You are going to start with 0. Okay, then 1. What is the number of objects they are given? 4. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Up to here, we have written very correctly. Okay, very neatly, we have sort of written it till, so it is not a problem. Okay, 4 objects, everything. See, this table is only important. You understand this table, half the work is done. Not half, almost 80% of the work is done. So these two things you wrote. This is with regard to objects from 0. This is with regard to weights, the entire thing. See, 0 will not have any impact. You will be seeing that later, okay? The next two things that you are going to write becomes again very important. The first thing is with regard to weights, okay, of this corresponding item. Okay, the weights of this corresponding item you are going to write. For weight 0, for the, you know, weight 0, it is 0 only. Okay, then for the next ones. Okay, then for the next one, you can see just below, sorry, not below, above, just above, you would have written what are the weights in ascending order. Okay, just above you only would have written the weights in ascending order. That only I'm going to write it here. Not going to change. Okay, what are the weights that you had? You had 2, okay, 3, 4, 5. Those things only are going to come here. What's the next thing? Next thing is the profits. Okay, even the profits need to be written. So I'm going to write that also, the profit of PI. Okay, so what are the things that you have in this profit of PI? All those corresponding profits will be written very clearly here. For the first one, be careful with it. For the first one, you'll not be having anything, obviously. Okay, so it will be 0. So from the next one, okay, you see this corresponding ones, we are going to write it. 1, 2, 5, 6. Check for weights 2, the profit is 1. Weight 2, the profit is 1. For weight 3, the profit is 2. For the weight 3, the profit is 2. Okay, so everything you have written very properly without any problem. What is the next thing? Next thing is you need to choose what is known as the putting values into this. How we are going to do that? That becomes the most important part here. Okay, so let me do that. Okay, let me put those values into it. Okay, let me put those values into it. How do you think that will be happening? It's a very simple procedure. Okay, common sense here. Most important part is common sense here. So let me put the values here. See, I need to, this is all weights. This is all the objects. This is all the weights. Now the weight is 0, profit is also 0. Be careful here. Weight is 0, profit is also 0. If the weight is also 0 here, okay, what you can put? Nothing. So the first one is obviously everything will be 0 only. Okay, you can't put anything there, right? So everything will be obviously even this one. Okay, everything will be 0 only. Okay, first one is everything will be equal to 0 only. The next part. So the next part, be careful with this. Okay, see this. This is the maximum weights and the weight of the weight is given here. Now the weight here is with regard to these are objects. Don't worry about the objects. Okay, don't worry about the objects. It's just, you know, first object. See, the weight here is 2. Okay, if the weight of the bag is 1, I can't put 2, right? Can I put 2? No, the weight is only 1. You can't put 2. And some may be thinking, you know, why you put only 1 out of the 2? No, it's now, you know, dynamic knapsack. You either put full or you don't put it at all. Okay, see, the weight is, if it is 1, I can't put 2. Okay, can I take this for example? See, in exam, they're not going to kg, pound and all. I'm going to take this kg. Okay? I'm going to consider this as kg for our understanding. Be careful here. I'm going to take this as for our own understanding. I'm going to write like this, that you are going to talk about kgs here. So if the weight of the knapsack is 1 kg, I can't put 2 kg here. Okay, I can't put it. So what I'm going to write, I'm going to write the same thing, that it is 0. If the weight of the bag is 2 kg, can I put these 2 kgs? Yes, I can put these 2 kgs. I can easily put that 2 kgs right here. So I've written 1. Why I've written 1? But easily that I can put that, you know, 2 kgs in here, because I'm selecting everything, that 1 will be coming right here. Okay, that 1 will be coming right here. Okay, then the next part. Then you see, if the weight is 3 kgs, 1 I've already put here. Okay, see, we have 2 kgs I've already put here. What I can put here? Nothing. There's nothing. Okay, if it is 4 kg, nothing I can put. So the same value will be coming towards the right hand side. This is what I told you. It's called trick. When you get a value like this, then the same old value will be coming here also, because you can't put anything. Okay, you can't put anything. The same old 2 kgs of where it came first. Okay, that you're going to put it here. Okay, then see, once that is all done, then you move to the next step, next one. Okay, next one. Now be careful here. What is it? The weight is 3 kgs. Okay, can you put it in 1? No. Can you put it in 2? No. Okay, can you put it in 3? Yes. I can put neatly that value right here. Okay, I can neatly put that value right here. Okay, and you have to be careful. Okay, these values is nothing but, see, the values that are getting filled right here are nothing but my profits. Okay, you can see very clearly the weight was 2 kg. So I put that 2 kg right here. And what was the profit? The profit was equal to 1. So I put that 1 here. Yes. Okay, so all, not just this, all these values are nothing but your profits. Okay, so I put that 1 here, and according to where it was 2 kg. Okay, and everything became 1 here. Now, if the weights is, see, now the weights, if it is saying 3 kg here, so where I can put the 3 kg? Okay, where I can put the 3 kg, that you need to figure out. So what is very simple? What's very simple technique? There's a formula for this. Anyway, first 2 rows, 3 rows, we'll figure out in our own strategy. Then the fourth row, I'll show you using formula. But because, you know, you need to implement formula, means a lot of multiple steps that will come. Otherwise, the common sense only we can use and put this, you know, fill up these values. But when you're showing it for the examiner, you have to show it using our formula only. That also will be able to do it. Okay, so what we are going to do today? Again, see this, the weight is 3 kg. So directly, without any problem, check for the weight that is having 3 here. There you are going to put the value. What your value you need to put? What is the profit? What is the profit with regard to 3 here? 2. That I'm going to put under 3. Towards the left hand side, be careful here. Towards the left hand side, whatever the value that you have, okay, on top, towards the left hand side, see, I put the value right here. Towards the left hand side, whatever the value that you there on the top, that only you are going to choose it and put it here. Or else, using formula also, if you do also, you get the same value. We are going to show that also. Okay, 0 and 1, you're getting it. Okay, 2, you got it. See, I put all my profit right here. Okay. I put all my profit right into this place. Now what is going to happen? Again, if I'm choosing this, I have to be careful that I can choose even these two things also. Okay, see, for this row, when I'm choosing, I was choosing only this row. when I'm doing it for this, I can take this entire thing, okay? I can take these two entire thing when I'm doing it for this entire two things, when I'm doing it for this row. Okay, so for that, what is the possibilities that you can have? Okay, you can see very clearly, okay, one is individually three, which is I have put it here. Okay, next is the combination of these two. When I go for combination of these two, what is the thing that you have? 3, 2, 3 plus 2, 5. So you can put there also. Check whether you have 5. Yes, there is a 5 here. Okay, and for 5, be careful. And for 5, what is the total profit you get? 2 plus 3 means here 1 plus 2. What is 1 plus 2? 3. I can put the value of 3 right here. And I told you, towards the left hand side, whatever the value that you have put it in the before one, that only will be coming right here. Okay, see, for 4, is there a possibility? No. Either it is 5 or 3. 3 individually or 5 with combination. Okay, the same thing only will be coming, just like how we put 1 here, the same thing only will be coming here, so this will become 2 only. Or is there a possibility? See, maximum is 5 only. Is there any other possibility that you can do? 2 plus 3, that's all. Either 3 individually or 2 plus 3, 5. Any other possibility? No. So all other things will remain 3 only. Okay. All other things will be remaining 3 only without any problem. This row is also over. Next, go for the next row. Again, you have to be careful here. Okay. What is the next thing I told you? If you are choosing this, if you want to do this one, we can do it like this. We can go for combinations also like this, or individually also we can do. So I am now talking about the row that you see right here. Okay, first we'll do individually. That's very important. First you need to do it individually. Individually, what is the weight? 4. You have 4 here? Yes. What is the profit there? 5. So I'm going to put that profit right here, 5. Directly over, yes. Now I'll go with combinations. Okay, before going there with combinations, see, 5 return come here. 5 came here. So obviously this row I don't have to worry at all, because this is the least that you can have. This is the least that you can have. Next is combination. Combinations will be more than this 5 only. Okay, so this is the least I can have. So what is the next thing I can do? Next thing is very simple. I can just copy whatever the values that were there towards this side. Now the same I can easily copy. Individually over, copying is also over. Yes. Next thing, I need to go here. I need to check the combinations now. What are the combinations I can have? I can have a combinations of all the 3. 1, 2, 3. Individually, 4 is over. Now, next thing is, I need to go with combinations. What are the combinations that are possible? 2 and 3, 5. 2 and 3 is 5. Okay. 2 and 3, maximum 8 is 5. Okay. I can go here. What is the profit I get? 3. But already 5 came here. Okay. Already 5 is coming here. So obviously, which is maximum? 5 only. Okay. So that 5 only you are going to write it right here. Okay. See, you are going to get it even in this formula also. I'll show you formula. For all those people who cannot go with this, you know, this is all common sense. Okay. It's a tricky method. What do you call it? Tricking, you know, small tricks you call it, right? Okay, where you can put the values directly without using formula. That I'm talking about. Okay, next, 2 and 3 combination over. Next, what's the other combination? 2 and 4. What is 2 and 4? 6. Is there a 6? Yes. What is the value when you go for 2 and 4? 6. What is the profits, corresponding profits you have? 1 and 5. Okay, 1 and 5. You can check this. 1 and 5. What is 1 and 5? 6. So for 6, it will automatically become 6 right here. So one combination is over. What are the combinations that you are? You are the first combination, 2, 3. Next combination is 2, 4. Next combination is 3, 4. For 2 and 3, the profit you got was 3. But you rejected this because the individual thing itself was more. Okay. Then for 2 and 4, okay, for 2 and 4, you can see 2 and 4, the value that you got was 6. So you put that 6, 2 and 4 means 6. So you put that value for 6. Then for 3 and 4 means 7. So where you got 7 here, right here. For 3 and 4, the profit that you get is 7. Are you putting that 7 here? Yes. So I'm going to put that 7 here. For 8, not possible. The same 7 only will continue. Okay, because the 8 is not possible. With these combinations, it's not ever possible. So 7 only will continue. Okay, this is all done. This is all fully done. Okay, now let me again go back and check with the last one. Now, once the last one is done, what we'll do is we'll again come back. We'll do it using formula. Okay, so then you'll get to know however you do it, you get the same values. This is easier because it's easier to do it. It's faster to do it. There, but in exam, can you do it directly like this? No. You do it, you get only few of the marks, not full of the marks. Okay, so let me go back and fill up the last value now. So what is the way of doing this? If I'm filling up the last value, okay, the last row like this, again, the combinations will vary. What are the combinations? Now I need to take the all the values. First, individually, I need to do it. Okay, so first I'll be doing it individually. What is the weight that is represented here? 5. Where is 5? 5 is right here. What's the profit that you have here? Individually, what is the profit that you have for 5? 6. Directly, I write 6. That's the least that you can have. This you have 6 here. All these tests, the same thing will come. 0, 1, 2, 5. Over. Only 3 rows only. 3, sorry. 3 cells only you need to fill up now. Okay. 3 cells only you need to fill up now. Let me do that. Okay. Let me do that. How do you do it? Again, I told you. Be careful. Individually, it's over. 5 it was there. Okay. So I went to 5. So what was the profit there? 6. So I put that 6 right here. Now it's all over. Okay, now I need to go with combinations. I have to be very careful with combinations. This is where whatever you learnt in permutations now will be coming into picture. How many combinations that you can have? There are 1, 2, 3, 4. If you choose, okay, you can choose in however way you want, but it should not exceed 8. That's very important. Okay, it should not exceed 8. So what are the combinations that I can have? I'll choose a bigger one. It's very simple, okay? See, it's very simple to take it. Choose the bigger one. 5. Combine that with the smaller ones. See, you have 2. I can choose 2 and 5. If I choose 2 and 5, what is the value I get? 7. 2 and 7. 2 plus 5 is equal to 7. For 7, okay, for 7, what is the profit you get? The corresponding profit. For 2, the corresponding profit is 1. For 1, for 5, the corresponding profit is 6. 1 plus 6, 7. This is weight. This is profit. Okay, where is 7 right here? Can I get directly write that 7 here? Yes. See, this was 6. Okay, this was 6. You got 7 value right here. So obviously this, okay, will be 6 only. It can't be more than 7. The 7 you're getting right here. Okay, you can check also. You can check, you're getting 6 only. You'll not get more than that. What is the thing that you can have? 4 and 2. 4 and 2 means 6 you get. What is 4? 5. Okay, corresponding profit for 4 is 5. For 2, it is 1. So 5 plus 1, 6. 6 only you get. However you do it, same thing only you get. That's mathematics. Okay, now the next combination, the bigger combination. 5. Okay, let me go for the next combination. Okay, I'll choose 5. Weight 5. Okay, weight is equal to 5. Now next weight I'll choose is the bigger one. Okay, 2 is over, so I'll do 3. So what is the total weight you get? 8. Now the corresponding profit to that. For 5, the corresponding profit is 6. Correct? The corresponding profit for 3 is 2. Okay, so what is 6 plus 2? Okay, what is the value that you get? It is equal to 8. This is with regard to profit. Have you got that corresponding combinations here? 6 and 2. Have you gone with 6 and 2? Okay, what is 6 and 2? 5 and 3. I've chosen 5 here and 3. Combinations 5 and 3. So what is the weight you got? 8. Okay. For 5 and 3, there is an 8 here. And what is the maximum profit you can have? 8. All filled up? Yes. Some people may be thinking, hey, choose 5 and 4, man. Okay, I'll choose. Okay. I'll choose the weight 5. Which is, this is again weight 5. I'll choose the weight 4. Okay, I'll choose a weight 4. 5 and 4. Weight is equal to 9. I told you the maximum knapsack size, okay, is equal to 8. You can't take 9 and all. If you, it was 9 means you would have taken the profit of 5 was, sorry, the profit corresponding to the weight 5 was 6. And for 4, it would have been 5. So you would have got the profit as 11. But this is not possible because the knapsack size itself is 8. Okay, so you got this values. Neatly, you got this, all these values. Okay, see, neatly you got these values. Entire row is filled up, sorry, entire columns is filled up. Entire table is filled up, yes. Maximum size was 8. Did you get that 8 here? Yes. Last value will always be 8 only. Now you got to know one important thing, that you figure out the values for each and every, you know, values. Right from 0 to 8. That's why it's called dynamic programming. You are going to figure out the values for each and everything. Yes, I figure out for each and everything. Okay, now the next thing. Now the next thing is, I need to know what is the object that was chosen, xi. Right, I need to see what is the object that was chosen. This is only table. Okay, I need to see the objects that were chosen so that I will figure out my, what is known as profit. What is maximum profit formula? Okay, the maximum profit formula is nothing but equal to what? Maximum profit is equal to summation of, you must be knowing this, okay, xi into pi. So I need to see what are the elements that are chosen. I'll multiply that with my profit. I'll be getting my maximum profit. But I need to see among the objects, what were the objects? The objects you had was with regard to four objects. Okay, four objects, 1, 2, 3, 4. We are not given the names of it, but you have taken as 1, 2, 3, 4. Among the objects, 1, 2, 3, 4, which objects have you chosen? For that, you need to do only simple thing. Okay, you need to figure out what are the values that are chosen. If you have chosen, you put 1. If you are not chosen, you put 0. That's all simple. Okay, to do that, what do you need to do? Very simple. I need to go in a way, okay, where I see this, I need to go from bottom to up. Okay, I need to go from bottom to up. How am I going to do that? Very simple. In the first thing, in the first last column you check. Okay, in the last column you check, what is my maximum value? Okay, what is my maximum value? The maximum value here is 8. Okay, the maximum value is with regard to 8 here. Okay, and where did you have that maximum value? The maximum value, you had it at 8 here itself. So you don't have to worry. Okay, or in this part itself, what is the combinations where you had this 8? Okay, the combinations that gave you that 8. The combinations that it gave you 8 was very simple, right? 8 means 6 and 2. Okay, 6 and 2. See, very simple, okay? 6 and 2 only gave you that 8. What was that 2? Okay, what was this 2? 2 is profit of which object? Second one. So, second one I have chosen. Then the 6 was profit of which one? Last one. So last one also I have chosen. Okay. And other two ones, I will not choose. But you should be careful. The maximum size was only 8. Are you exceeding 8? Weight of second one. Be careful. I'm going to write the weight once. Weight you check. For the first one, I have not chosen it. The weight was 2. The second one, I have chosen it. The weight was, be careful, 3. Okay. Third one, I have not chosen it. The weight was 4. Fourth one, I have chosen it. The weight was 5. What is the weight? Summation of your, whatever the objects you have chosen, the maximum weight. Okay. The maximum weight equal to summation of your weight that you have chosen into xi. What is the weight? Okay. Which is the one what you have chosen? 1 into 3. Or 3 into 1, however you call it, okay? Plus the one that you have chosen, 1 into 5. 3 plus 5, 8. Maximum size is 8. I'm satisfying it. Not a problem. Not at all a problem. Now, that's not the end of it, right? I need to figure out my profits. What is profit? The maximum profit. Okay, the maximum profit, just now I told you. maximum profit is nothing but summation of xi into pi. Do I get that? Okay, figure out where and all I have xi. This one, 1 into what is the corresponding profit of that? For one, what is the corresponding profit of this, which is with regard to which object? Second object. Or else one more step I'll take. Okay, so it becomes even more easier. Okay, so let me take one more step. I'll write one more step, not a problem. Okay, so that you will get a neat idea of what is the corresponding profits. So can I write the corresponding profits of all these things? Pi is equal to, okay, for 2, 3, 4, 5. What was the profits? You wrote just like 2, 3, 4, 5. The profits was 1, 2, 5, 6. Okay, now you tell me the maximum profit equal to, okay, summation of xi into pi, which is equal to, okay, 0 into 1. I'll write the full thing. 0 into 1 plus, okay, 1 into 2 plus 0 into 5. This one and this one I'm doing. Okay, 0 into 5 plus 1 into 6. What is the value you get? 0 into 1, 0, plus 1 into 2, 2, plus 0 into 0, 5, 0, plus 1 into 6, equal to 8. Knapsack size was also 8. Maximum profit you got was also 8. Have you got this 8 here? Yes. Which are the two combinations? 2 and 6. You got that thing? Yes. Have you got that entire thing right here? Yes. That's all is a problem. Okay? That's all is a problem.